Welcome to the Powerhouse, a house for worship, a house of prayer, a house with hope, love, respect, with the one and only Bishop Dr. Kofi Adonse Boateng. Welcome to the Divine Word.
Is you drive and you are drunk,
and the police stops you. They call you that you are driving under the influence of what? So if I want to go here, my purpose is to go there, and I continue to drink, I might end up sometimes under the influence. You will fall down. I am preaching on the topic under the not alcohol, but I said under the influence. I said I am preaching on the topic under the somebody work at a company very diligently, steadfastly, just working because the person loves the job. Another person hated this person so much for no reason. You know, sometimes people can hate you for no reason. Just because you are beautiful. Just because you are nice. Just because you have something somebody do not have. For some strange reason, somebody can hate you for nothing. The person went to management meeting with the intent to go and report to management that this person who has been working very diligently, her work report is very bad, so they should fire the person. You understand? A manager has gone to a managerial meeting with this hardworking lady's name to go and get the person fired. But when she went to the meeting with the intent to report negatively for this woman to be fired, something strangely happened. She went going to report negatively for this woman to be fired. But when she went to the meeting, something happened. When she mentioned the name of the lady, and they were waiting for her to give a negative report, she began to say, she is very good. She is very, very diligent. She works very hard. She went with the mindset of her own to destroy this lady, but under the anointing of the Holy Spirit, oh, her mind began to change. Hey. She began to wobble.
Jesus.
The plans of your enemies,
hey,
I prophesy in the name of Jesus,
hey,
under the influence of the Holy Spirit,
Jesus,
and the plan,
hey,
and the witch,
hey,
and the devil,
hey,
and the plot,
hey,
in the name of Jesus,
hey,
it shall turn around.
Hey.
It shall turn around.
Hey.
They can't kill you.
Yeah.
Lift up your hand and say,
receive it.
The plan was to get the lady fired. But just as she was about to report negatively about this lady, when David was anointed as a king, nobody knew anything about David apart from the family of David and the prophet Samuel. When he anointed David, spiritually, the Bible said power came upon. Strangely, Goliath came and fought. David went and stood before Goliath and whooped him. Automatically, David became a star. Anytime man realizes you to be a different person among certain people, strangely, they hate you.
Yes.
If you are better than them, if you look good than them,
yes,
if you are smarter than them,
yes,
if you are richer than them,
yes,
if you are wiser than them,
yes,
they tell us you,
yes,
they hate you.
Yes.
But today, whatever they have planned,
yes,
whatever they have purposed,
yes,
under the influence of the Holy Ghost,
yes,
they cannot stop you.
Yes.
They cannot stop you.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
After David killed Goliath, the king at the time became jealous and decided to kill him. But let me tell you, for every human being who lives on the surface of this earth, It doesn't matter your current status situation. God still has plans for you.
Amen.
That is why if you are blessed to receive certain things in your life today and somebody has not gotten it, don't be too quick to laugh. Because tomorrow the situation might change.
Yes.
Tomorrow the story might change.
Yes.
Tomorrow their destinies might change.
Yes.
Certain things might happen.
Yes.
The thing they don't have today, they might receive it tomorrow.
Yes.
God bless you and receive it in the name of Jesus.
It.
After David killed Goliath, the king Saul decided to kill David. But there's a saying in Ghana that Abubrokosia. How do I say this in English? Abubrokosia. Adia ebeye ye ensaida.
Oh, konsama Yesu on away.
Yes. If you go to 1 Samuel 19 verse 1 and 2.
The book of 1 Samuel chapter 19 verse 1.
And 2. Go ahead.
And 2. Saul told his son Jonathan and all the attendants to kill David. But Jonathan had taken a great liking to David and warned him.
Jonathan is the son of David. The father Saul as a king has plotted to kill David. You know, one of the things I want to advise everybody. Anytime you plan to do any human evil, look at yourself that this that I'm going to do to this sister or brother, if it's done to me, how will I feel about it? If you pull a knife to cut my tongue, remember you have a tongue inside your mouth. So as you pull in my tongue to cut it, think about your tongue. Okay? Unya unyonko, na ya osa say no. Bunanimase, kanu wansem ne, ya jina onso sa di amiko yei. Sa anyo onuana say emia. If you find me and you are talking evil about me and you are insulting me, think about your husband at home. That if I were that your husband in the house, how would you feel if another woman is talking about me? You better shut your mouth up.
Yes.
Saul had planned to kill David. Saul had plotted to kill David. But you know what? David is an anointed boy. People who are anointed, if you are messing around with them, be careful.
Jeez.
Anybody who is anointed, obi bi onyame nsada no so no. Sa wo be yeye o sa fa on sa kokan na jene ho ansa. No onyame be tie wo ka se na onyuma so tie. He plotted to kill David. But his own son went to David and said, David, yo, run away. My father wants to kill you. His own son. Listen to me. I'm preaching on the topic where? Under the
influence.
So David ran away. Go to verse 18. 1 Samuel 1, verse 18.
The book of 1 Samuel chapter 19.
Yeah.
Verse 18.
After David ran away, what happened?
When David had fled and made his escape.
He ran away, yes.
He went to Samuel at Ramah.
Samuel, the prophet.
Yes, sir.
Please, if you are in trouble and you are running away, don't run away anywhere. Go to the house of God. If you can run away to anywhere and find comfort and protection anywhere, go to the house of God. Say amen to that.
Amen.
Saul was looking to kill David. He ran away to the man who anointed him. Prophet Saul. He ran away because David knew that his protection, the anointing upon him, came from who? Prophet Samuel. Because he poured oil on him. If anything can happen anywhere, in the presence of the prophet, there's a big protection. That's why I tell you that any church you go, look at the protection upon that man of God. It is the same protection that covers you.
Jesus. Amen.
So when David knew that Saul was coming after him to kill him, he ran away to prophet Samuel. What happened?
When David had fled and made his escape,
yes,
he went to Samuel at Ramah and told him all that Saul had done to him.
Yes.
Then he and Samuel went to Naioth and stayed there.
Naioth is like a church. They went to a church and stayed there. He said, he that dwelleth at the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow
of the Almighty.
So they went to the house of God. And what happened?
Verse 19.
Yes.
Word came to Saul. David is in Naioth at Ramah.
Somebody got concerned. Went to the king Saul. and said, that boy you are looking for, he's in that house. He's sitting at the corner. Look, let me tell you something. You might be here as an ordinary person. People may see you ordinary. If you go to your bank, they see you because the woman typed the thing and see that you have a negative account. They see you ordinary. But I'm telling you, no matter what they see about you, they don't really know the power of God upon you.
Jesus.
Today they see negative. Yeah. But tomorrow that story will turn around. By the presence of God and the power of God, everything will turn around for you. Say amen.
Amen.
They went to Saul and reported that that boy David is in that church. Go and kill him. And what did Saul do?
Word came to Saul, David is in Nayoth at Ramah.
Mm-hmm.
So he sent men to capture him.
He sent people to go and do what?
To capture him.
To capture David.
Yes, sir.
To kill him.
Yes, sir.
Okay, go ahead.
But when they saw a group of prophets.
When the people King Saul sent to go and capture David.
Mm.
You remember I told you David was in the house of God with Prophet Samuel.
Jesus.
And it was a church. Everybody's heart was elevated to the Almighty God and praising Jesus. The people went there to arrest David to kill him. When they got to the church and opened the door, oh, and what happened?
But when they saw a group of prophets prophesying.
They saw the prophet prophesying.
Yes, sir.
Normally, prophets prophesy under the influence of the Holy Spirit. Mm. Prophets prophesy under the influence of the Holy Spirit. They went there to capture David. But when they saw the prophet prophesying under the influence of the Holy Spirit, what happened, my friend?
But when they saw a group of prophets prophesying.
Yes.
With Samuel standing as their leader.
Yes.
The Spirit of God came upon Saul's men.
The Spirit of God came upon Saul's men.
Yes,
the men who have been sent to go and arrest David.
Yes, sir.
The same Spirit came upon them. What did they start doing?
The Spirit of God came upon Saul's men. And they also prophesied.
The people went there to kill David.
Hey.
But under the influence of the Holy Spirit,
may God confuse your enemies. May God confuse your enemies. They can destroy you. Lift up your hand and say, yes.
When they go to the house of God, they were carrying knives and guns to kill David. But immediately they entered the place. They were looking for David. But when they entered, the people were praying. All of a sudden, the people who were looking for David, they have never spoken in tongues before. They have never prophesied before. But under the anointing of the Holy Spirit, under the influence, they started.
May God confuse your enemies. May God confuse your enemies. Lift up your hands.
Somebody has planned to destroy you. But God will use the plans of your enemies to destroy you, to promote you.
Hey.
I said God will use the plans of your enemies to destroy you, to promote you. You shall be elevated. You shall be the head. You shall be on top. You shall be number one. 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 Lift up your hands and shout,
receive it.
Under the influence, they got confused.
Mumbo munyamidi. Mumbo munyamidi. Mumbo munyamidi. Mumbo munyamidi. Yesu nyami awachasha. Yesu nyami awachasha. Yesu nyami awachasha.
Oh,
nyami awachasha. Yes, you got me out of Tasha.
They came about to destroy you. The plan was to destroy you. But I said, I saw God turning the situation. I see God turning your situation around. I see God turning the situation around. Lift up your hand and say,
I receive it.
When the men got there to arrest David, they changed their mind under the influence and they started prophesying. When the first group got there, they didn't go back. They joined the congregation and they also started
prophesying.
Go ahead.
Verse 21.
Yes.
Saul was told about it.
He was told that the people you sent, they changed their mind. They are prophesying good things about David. The people you sent to arrest David, now they went there, they are fools. They have changed their mind. And while the prophet Samuel is blessing David, they are also making rabatoko toko. So, go ahead.
Saul was told about it.
Yes.
And he sent more men.
He sent
more men.
More. At first he said he sent two, now he sent more.
More men.
Okay. You know, if you send more people to come here and spy, the congregation is going to increase. Oh,
yes.
If you send people here to come and spy this congregation, I say, Ayo, Danano. Go ahead.
Saul was told about it.
Yeah.
And he sent more men.
Mm-hmm.
And they prophesied too.
When the people also got there, under the influence, not of acquisition. Under the influence, not of anything, but the Holy Ghost, power of God, anointing.
Jesus.
May you be blessed. Oh. May you be anointed. Oh.
Amen.
Amen. The people also changed. So, King Saul is losing men. Prophet Samuel is gaining men. Because the more he sent them, the more they go there and join the congregation. So they sent one person to come and spy. That person heard that song, and he lifted a hand. Then they sent four more. So if the church is 200, four more is going to be 300 and what? Four. Then they also came. Then they said, Ayamudana. They also say,
ah.
So go ahead.
Saul sent men a third time.
A third time?
Yes, sir.
A third time, he's sending more.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
And they also prophesied.
When they also got there,
hey,
under the influence of the Holy Ghost,
hey,
they began to say, so nyami shrew.
I receive it.
I receive it. Now the congregation is growing. They plan to hurt you. But the more they plan to hurt you, the more God continues to bless you. The more they plot evil about you, the more good things happens in your life. That is why I say this week, you know, Onyame Israel.
I receive.
That is why I say this week, God bless you.
I receive.
That is why I say this month, God bless you.
I receive.
Amen.
Amen.
What happened? That person is sending people to go kill. What happened to him?
Verse 22.
22.
Finally.
Finally.
He himself.
Hold on. Listen. When the enemy comes fighting you, everybody listen to me very carefully. There is nothing on this earth that has a beginning and it doesn't have an end. If you ask, Adie bia wa asha si e bia no. Osoro be kasa. Minya mi be kasa.
Esan bebreba. Yana minamu yo. Osoro be kasa. Amama koma chomiye.
Enkaodo.
Enkaoda.
Ensemble enkaodo.
Enkaoda.
Enkaodo.
Enkaoda.
Amani enkaodo.
Enkaoda. Isebebe baya. Yada bida uyo. Osoro bekasa. Amama koma.
After effort and effort and effort has been made to kill somebody because God has blessed the person, after effort and effort has been made to destroy an innocent life, after effort and effort has been made to destroy your purpose and goals in life, there is coming a time you will lift up your hand and say, Lord, I give you praise. And maybe Baba Peter won't say no, I can say what they made our say. My time for we are Yaba. The end of your enemies has come. The end of your enemies has come. Say,
yes.
Finally, what happened?
Finally, he himself left for Ramah.
Hey, they sent a witch. They sent a wizard. They sent a demon. They sent a principality. After they tried everything. Normally, this is how it works in the spirit. When they try everything and you are not going down, now Satan himself. So you realize that Jesus Christ, they took him through a lot of things. He has to die and go and meet Satan. Jesus must die to go and meet Satan in hell. Finally, Jesus is going to face Satan. Satan is wearing a boxing glove, a very big one like my muff. He was standing there ready to fight Jesus. But I wish that your enemies knows the power that is inside you.
Yeah.
Because he that is inside you is greater than he that lives in the world.
Yeah.
You are two mono. What's the city of your soul? What to me, who? What to me, sound? What to me, Mrawasi? What to me, Muanamasi? No weapon that is fastened against you shall prosper. Lift up your hand and say,
receive it. Shirano.
When Jesus Christ died, he prophesied that on the third day, he will do what? He will do what? So they went one, they went two, they went three. Most of them You remember that the Bible said, but when they got to the house and they saw the people prophesying,
Jesus,
they also started prophesying.
Yes, sir.
But when he came to Saul, on his way to kill David, this is the church. The train is waiting, and they are waiting for the train to pass for him to come and catch me. He's sitting in the car. But at that time, the people had prayed and prophesied and prophesied. So normally, if we are here and we pray a lot, all this area, the anointing covers everywhere.
Jesus.
Yeah. So they had prayed. David knew that they want to kill him. So he was laying on the floor. So he was praying. And the people who were sent by Saul, they also came there. And they were praying for David. They came there to catch him. But they were also praying for him. David, when you best rain, obey makeup. One no lipstick, one no lip gloss. But Saul, the king, he didn't get to the house. But far away on the way, the Bible used one word. Go ahead, read it again, Michelle.
So Saul went to Naioth at Ramah. But the Spirit of God came even on him.
Listen to the language. Even. Even. It means that even though he is a king, the thing has touched the people, and he is angrily going to fight. Even he. The bank is about to put money in your account.
Jesus.
Your bank is about to deposit the big money in your account. The bank is about to deposit big money in your account. Lift up your hand and shout.
Receive it.
Read on for me, my friend.
He walked along prophesying until he came to Naioth.
Now he is there.
Yes.
Now he is in the church.
Yes.
Now go ahead.
Verse 24. He stripped off his garments.
When he got there.
Jesus.
He stripped off his
garments.
So he took off his shirt. All the people were wearing their shirt. But now, under the influence of the Holy Spirit, this man, Akino, he began to remove his shirt. And then when he removed his shirt, they thought it was enough. Then he did this. And then the people said, what is he doing? He removed his shirt. Then he removed his pants. When he removed his pants, the people thought it was enough. Then he began to... And then what did he continue to do?
He stripped off his garments. And he too prophesied.
And then he too
prophesied.
When he took off everything, the people couldn't look at him because now there is nothing. But they were shocked. A whole king, a whole you, look at you, look at your notes in your face. Look, you. So the people were trying to look away because this is a king, we can't disrespect him. So they thought he was going to angrily tear David up. Then he said, David, you, I prophesy in the name of Jesus. You will be the next king of Israel. You will be the next king. You will be the next billionaire in the genius. Lift up your hand and say,
receive it.
Let me let you know, in case you don't know. Let me announce to you, in case you don't know, that from this day going forward, any agenda, any plan of anybody to disgrace you, you shall receive honor.
I receive it.
Any plan of anybody to put you in trouble, you shall be blessed.
I receive it.
Any trouble by anybody to make you poor, you shall prosper.
I receive it.
Any trouble to make your marriage break up, your marriage shall be sweet.
I receive it.
Any trouble by anybody to destroy your marriage shall be better.
I receive it.
God will put your feet on a rock.
I receive
it. You shall sing a new song.
I receive
it. You shall sing a new song.
I receive
it. You shall sing a new song.
I receive
it. You shall sing a new song.
I receive
it. You shall sing a new song.
I receive
it. You are blessed.
I receive
it. You are blessed.
You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed.
The king himself who went there to kill David, he has removed the king's clothing. You know why he removed it? You know why he removed his clothing? Because David is going to wear it very soon. I said David is going to. Into the plan they are planning to disgrace you, God will put you to the next level. I said God will put you to the next level. God will lift you to the next level. God will lift you to the next level. God will lift you to the next level. Lift up your hand and say, I
ray.
Are you done?
No, sir.
Go ahead, let me see what is there.
He stripped off his garment and he too prophesied in someone's presence.
He prophesied. Remember, David is operating under the anointing and protection of who?
Samuel.
So anybody who comes here, God is ahead. But as I stand here, the covering of the Lord that is upon me protects everybody.
Jesus.
So if a witch follows you here to attack you, Laba Kaba, Lema, Lama, Lebe, 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 Le, 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 no weapon that is fastened against you shall prosper. No weapon, no weapon, no weapon, no weapon, no weapon. Lift up your hands and say,
Yes.
Finish it.
He lay naked all that day and all that night.
When all of them were just prophesying. When he alone got there, he lay there. Remember, he's not wearing his dress. So he lay there.
May God cause your enemies to fall down before you. May God cause your enemies to say amen.
So the people began to ask, this Saul, is he now part of divine? That man who has been insulting divine and always talking about Kofi Adon Tibuati is now going to be an usher here. God is going to turn my table around. I said God is going to turn the situation around. Your situation will turn around. He will set the table before you in the presence of your
enemies.
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 Amen.
Amen.
My friend, I'm done.
Amen.
But go to John 15, verse 12. You know today is Palm. Oh, today, and is it not today? When is Palm Sunday? Next week. I started mine today, so here. Read on.
The book of John chapter 15 verse 12. My command is this.
Jesus is talking. My command is this. Go ahead.
Love each other as I have loved you.
Everybody here, before I go, everybody, we all claim we are Christians. But to have Christ in your life is nothing if there is no love. This is just by the way, but I want to make sure I shoot this like a bullet inside your heart. When I was preaching, most of you said I receive it. Most of you said amen. But everything I said, if Jesus is not there, and even Jesus is there and there is no love, you are hopeless. Jesus said, what? Why?
This is my command to you.
Mm-hmm.
Love each other as I have loved you.
Jesus said, if you want to be part of this church, please, any hatred, enmity, enviness, gossip. Sometimes people are very stupid. I am a very, very smart individual. I'm not bragging. I am very, 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 very smart. If all of you, if you are dealing with me, be very careful. Because before normally, if you come to me and you're talking, before you finish, I have already synchronized and metabolized you,
hey,
and I know where you are going. People come to me and talk about people. Some people are even confident enough to come and talk to me about my wife. Yeah, they do that. They want to try if they can bring a separate Separation. But what I love, I love.
Yes.
You know, go.
Hey. Yeah, man.
They come talking about you. But let me tell you something. In the house of God, if you have love inside, when you come destroying this innocent woman to me, be careful that somebody can also go and destroy you too. So in the house of God, we must just love your neighbor as your what?
Sir.
Go ahead.
My command is this.
Yeah.
Love each other as I have loved you.
Mm-hmm.
Greater love has no one than this.
Yeah, go ahead, go ahead.
To lay down one's life for one's friends.
Jesus said, there is no greater love like anything. Like he has laid his life for all of us.
Jesus.
He didn't hold anything back. He gave all his life away. Go ahead.
You are my friends. If you do what I command.
You are my friends. If you do what I command. Yeah. Go ahead.
Verse 15.
Verse 15, yeah.
I no longer call you servants.
Hold on. Your Bible says servant, but in some of the scriptures, Jesus didn't even call, he said slaves. Mm. So before, Jesus is saying that before we were slaves. Listen, before we were slaves, but after he has laid his life for all of us, he is no longer calling us servant or slaves, but what is he calling us?
I no longer call you servants. Because a servant does not know his master's business.
A servant does not know his servant. A servant or a slave does not know his master's business. But who?
Instead, mm-hmm. I have called you friends. For everything that I learned from my father, I have made known to you.
Everything Jesus Christ brought on this earth, he said, I have given it to you. Nobody here is a slave.
Hey.
Nobody here is a criminal.
Hey.
Nobody here is a sinner.
Hey.
We are all saved by the mercies and the grace of God.
Oh, Jesus.
There are no classes in Christianity. Hey. There are no better people in Christianity.
Hey.
We are all here by the sheer grace of God. So those of you who see yourself masters and you see others as slaves, over here, there is no slave. Everybody is a master's son. Everybody is a master's daughter. Everybody, tonight you are blessed.
I
receive. Rise up and say, amen.
It is amazing what praises can do. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. This is Bishop Kofi Adonteim Boateng from Divine Word International Ministries, Virginia, USA. I encourage you to watch the message, the Word of God, the Rhema Word of God, which is miracle, which is power, and is anointed, and your life will be blessed. Amen.